Hello and welcome back to another segment of Gran Turismo 7 segment plays. We're gonna go ahead and get into this DTG menu a little bit. So, let's get started on that. I had to add a ballast, which I think is better. Then needing to buy more. I was in a pickle because I didn't know which one of these. Mazda has two of these. So I picked the one I thought the one it was asking for. But I think I got the stronger one. Enough talk. All right. Let's get it. Down. Oh, shit. No, I don't want it. Catch the beginning part of this. Yeah. Savage. This will be interesting. Yeah, blame me. I was bumper in the face. Maybe I didn't need a VGT for this. Just as well. Come on, come on, come on. Work with me a little. What is it doing? car is breaking, could use some work. My driving could use some work.
Thank you.
Yo, that's all three for this menu. Was thinking about just having this replay on for a sec while I chat for a little bit. Depending on how noisy the engine is, actually. This series of races made me think of a couple things. So, one of which was, every Gran Turismo player has their own thing they're really good at. Some people are really good at rally, some people are really good at drifting, some people are really good at, you know, under 500 PP sprints, what have you. And, you know, even if you're not that good at it, it's awesome that you'd be interested anyway. But point being, this VGT class felt like how I think I would be good at one of these games is, you know, braking responds correctly, quick movement, good weight class. EGT just felt like something very comfortable. Not to say that I'm not going to specialize in drifting, you know, I drifted up the show. But, you know, just from start to finish with this game, you know, you start with the weaker cars. Yeah, they're easier to control at high speeds or their top speeds, but they actually brake fucked up, they don't turn correctly. This VGT class does it just right. Now, I don't know at which point it was the first race, the third, or not the second, or this one. But there's a point when this car started to just feel very natural. I don't know if that's a familiarity with driving other Mazda cars, or if they just did a unique thing this time that's good because of unrelated reasons, but this car started to feel very comfortable for me. So, you know, combo of a class that I've just, you know, stepped into, I think is a really good fit for me. And also this car. I doubt there's another VGT car I'll have to get. This thing is awesome. And I think this is the car I remember regretting not getting in GT Sport. I was like, oh man, there was a sick-ass Mazda, I should have got that. Damn right you should have got that. It's fucking awesome. Even with added weight. It's a great car. With that being said, this will also be my final race of the evening. I won't be doing any more racing tonight. Tomorrow I'll be back on. I'd like to polish off as many of these videos as possible. I think when I bought this car, I unlocked another menu, so. Never-ending story. But, yeah, this VGT series of races, Friday night, let's bring the fireworks. That was the main event. That was this week's hurrah, you know. We let them bang, and that's what it was. If you deny it, I challenge you to go back to the last race. It was flying. By which point here, I was hardly challenged, but there are points throughout the evening where I relied on muscle memory from the track and just knowing what my talents are, knowing what they're not.
let's carry on.
I'm far too curious to know what we get out of all that shit. Relay ticket. Nice. We like that. Okay, well that's just as well. I'd rather keep the money. Let's have a look at the next menu that we're gonna pick. We might just spend the rest of this video just kind of scoping things out, maybe getting prepared for the next few races. So, K Lightweight Cup. Okay, this thing. Let's hold off on that. G1 prototype. Is this something that we have? I think the one I have classifies for that. Enter Neoclassical, I think I have that. The Sylvia Sisters. Okay, we can take care of that. Stark Sports Car Masters, what's this about? Oof. Horrible. Horrible tracks. Oh my god, that's gonna be nasty. What cars? Hold off on that until the last, actually, because the cars that are necessary potentially to do well here are very expensive. I don't know if I have any, and the odds are me having one in time for this are greater if I do it later. What's this about? Yeah, this one's nasty. I know what exactly what they're putting in there. That might be second to last. What's Jimny Cup? Oh, nice. Okay, well, that's something we'll have fun with. Maybe we'll start here to have fun. But right off the top, I would like to, right off the dome, put some work into this Lady Eve. And we'll take care of that mission also tomorrow. We'll take care of the work part of that, and I don't know what the other things. There were two K-car things that will be done, but what I'm gonna get up to now is something I know that will appreciate, assuming that there's not a PP regulation. So let's actually find out. Mitsubishi. Yeah, let's get in this thing. And let's commit to the series. So I think that'll be a good thing for me to just pick up and do tomorrow. The Sylvia sisters. I was trying to come up with a funny Mr. Garvey joke for that. We're just looking at stats for now. What's suggested? So we can max out. Let's make this thing fucking strong. Even though we're probably gonna regret it a little bit. Fuck it. All out. Dirt, intermediate, heavy, wet. Let's get those just in case. Best muffler. Best air filter. Best racing intercooler. Dip it down. Oh, is that dirty? been the best move. What was it that I did that wasn't a good thing to do? Was in this page. There was some computer I got last time that made a big difference that I was not aware of. Is it this? Yeah, fully customizable computer. That makes a huge difference. Alright, folks, well, I gotta clip it here. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one. Please visit my shop at segment.click online superstore, just as my profile name is pretty much anywhere. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.